Hi, my name is Xilong Chen. I'm a principal research statistician developer at SAS. In this video, I would like to tell you about how to use time series tools for scenario analysis and portfolio optimization. There is a long list of modern time series tools available to you in SAS ETS, SAS Econometrics, and other SAS products. In this video, I focus on two of them, the VARMAX procedure and the HMM procedure, and their applications in two areas, scenario analysis and portfolio optimization. Scenario analysis deals with future events in alternative future worlds. It has been widely applied in macroeconomics, finance, politics, and other fields. One of the most famous examples is in CCAR, bank stress testing. The Federal Reserve provides the future macro scenarios, and the banks respond with the corresponding forecasts. In this video, we will use some examples to show how to incorporate the scenario information into the forecast in order to produce the so-called conditional forecast. As you might expect, producing a conditional forecast is a very difficult task in both theory and practice. However, when you use the VARMAX procedure, it becomes pretty easy. Here's a plot of two simulated time series, showing 60 years of quarterly data. For convenience, we use the GDP and the interest rate to name the series. Assume that you are interested only in the GDP forecast for the next 3 years. First, let's produce the unconditional forecast. Here's the plot of the unconditional forecast. The point forecast and its 95% confidence interval. Is this forecast good? Because the data are simulated, the actual values for the next 3 years are available. They are plotted on the graph as black dots. You can see that the unconditional forecast is not very good. The 95% confidence interval covers only 75% of the realized value. But without any additional information, that's the best you can do. Now, let's assume that more future information is available, as shown in scenario 1. Assume that the interest rates in the next 3 years are falling linearly. As shown in this table and plot, in the first scenario, three exact values in the future path of interest rates are known. How will this scenario information influence the forecast? You can find this out by using the count for statement in PROC VARMAX. Count for stands for conditional forecast. We skip the details, and here is the conditional forecast for scenario 1. Put the unconditional forecast in the picture, and you can see how different it is from the conditional forecast. Moreover, in this example, the conditional forecast has a much better forecast performance than the unconditional forecast. Let's move on to the second example. In this example, the scenario is defined by bounds, but not exact values. Here, the interest rate is above 2 in 2020, between negative 2 and 2 in 2021, and below negative 2 in 2022. Could you get the conditional forecast for this scenario? Let PROC VARMAX handle it. Here is the conditional forecast for scenario 2. As the plot shows, it's different from and better than the unconditional forecast. What happens if the scenario consists of both exact values and bounds? Again, leave it to PROC VARMAX. You get the conditional forecast for scenario 3, which is different from and better than the unconditional forecast again. Are you wondering why the conditional forecast in all three scenarios is better than the unconditional forecast? That's because in all three scenarios, there is some correct information about the future. The actual values of interest rates in the next 3 years are plotted as the dotted line in each scenario. They do fall from about positive 2 to about negative 6. Let's try something different. In scenario 4, the interest rate move upward, but the actual interest rate move downward. That's the information in this scenario is wrong. You still get a conditional forecast that's different from the unconditional forecast, but this time the conditional forecast is worse. In fact, this is good news for us, right? It means that the conditional forecast actually uses the scenario information, no matter whether that information is right or wrong. In the previous slides, all the examples were based on Bayesian vector autoregressive models. In fact, conditional forecasting is also supported for the Bayesian vector error correction models. Although conditional forecasting is very difficult to implement, it's critical for scenario analysis. PROC VARMAX can make your work much easier. Now let's shift gears and talk about another topic where SAS econometrics software is useful, portfolio optimization, whose core is the risk-return trade-off. Let's consider a simple portfolio in which there are two choices, bonds and stocks. For simplicity, the bonds are fixed at an annual rate of 1.35%. The stocks are the CRSP market index, which is similar to the SP 500. Here's the plot of 92 years of stock prices from 1926 to 2017. In this example, the first 75 years of data are used for training, and the last 17 years of data are used for testing. We want to use this data to compare different trading strategies. The trading strategies can be very complex. Let's start with simple benchmark strategies. You can hold only bonds the whole time. That's a risk-free strategy. Or you can hold only stocks the whole time. That's a market strategy. These two benchmark strategies are model-free. We can directly draw the wealth curve. Assume that at the beginning of 2001, you have $1. If you hold bonds the whole time, 17 years later, you will end up with $1.25. That's your wealth increases 25%. Instead, if you hold stocks the whole time for the same period, you end up with $2.14, which means your wealth increases 114%. Here, the market strategy seems the winner. In fact, most of the time, you are trying to find a strategy that's better than the market strategy so that you can beat the market. If you knew the market state, bull or bear, you might be able to devise better strategies. For example, if you are in a bull market, you buy and hold stocks. If you are in a bear market, you sell stocks and hold bonds. However, before we test whether these strategies are better than the market strategy, we need to answer two questions. First, what does a bull or bear market actually mean? Because you cannot directly observe them. Second, how can we forecast these market states? To answer these questions, we will use the Hidden Markov Model. You might have heard this model referred to by different names, such as the state space model, random switching model, and so on. It's one of the most popular machine learning tools for time series analysis, and it has been widely applied in economics, finance, science, and engineering. The Hidden Markov Model contains two chains. One chain is what you can observe, like stock prices, or there are different statistician reversion stock returns. The other chain cannot be directly observed, like market states, and those hidden states follow a Markov chain. The distribution of the first chain of observables becomes independent, conditional on the second chain of hidden states. We will let PROC HMM use the first 75 years of data to find the best model. In this example, it needs about 10,000 CPU hours to finish the training and select the model. The winner is a 8-state AR4 hidden Markov model. What does that mean? It means we need 8 different kinds of AR4 process to describe the market state. After interpreting the Markov chain, we can find out, first, there are three market states, bull market, transition market, and the bear market, not just two market states, bull and bear. Second, three hidden states with small risk describes the bull market. Three hidden states with medium risk describe the transition market. And two hidden states with high risk describe the bear market. Therefore, we can answer the first question about what the market states are. Now for the second question, how to forecast those market states? This becomes very easy. You apply the selected model to the out-of-sample data, and you get the forecast in just 1 second. The forecast shown in this plot might not be what you expect. It's talking about the probability distribution of market states. It's a lot like the weather forecast. Tomorrow, there is a 30% chance of rain. And here, next week, there is a 30% chance of a bear market. In the forecast for each week, the sum of probabilities of the three market states is always 1. The plot stacks these three probabilities for each week. With this forecast of market states in hand, we are ready to construct the trading strategies. This is like deciding whether or not to take your umbrella according to the weather forecast. If there is a 30% or greater chance of rain, take the umbrella. Otherwise, don't. Here, the bear strategy is that if there is a 30% or greater chance of a bear market, sell the stock. The bull strategy considers the trading from another view. If there is a 10% or greater chance of a bull market, buy and hold the stock. These strategies look simple, but in fact, they are quite powerful. They both beat the market. Compared to the market strategy, they perform about 10% better in returns and 60% better in the Sharpe ratio. However, they might not be the final winner. Considering that the market will go up when it reaches its lowest point, you might choose to buy the stock even when you are in a bear market. Here's the final strategy. You sell the stock only if the chance of a bear market is between 30% and 75%. Otherwise, you buy and hold the stock. This strategy beats the market performance by 40% in returns and performs 50% better in the Sharpe ratio, which is the purple line shown in the plot. In this video, I introduced you to two time series tools, PROC VARMAX for scenario analysis and PROC HMM for portfolio optimization. SAS offers many other modern time series tools. Choose the ones that are most suited to your needs and feel free to contact me with any questions. Thank you for your watching.